A lot of early music in most cultures was monophonic, a simple melody sung by a voice or played on an instrument with no accompaniment. This means one person would sing with no other music playing, what we call a cappella, or an instrument would play a simple melody with no other instrument playing. There was no concern about being in tune with another voice or instrument since there was only one being sounded. This also meant that only one note was played at a time. Musical intervals would be heard as one note followed by another, but not as more than one note being played at the same time. But we should mention, when one note is playing by itself, it is possible to hear other frequencies or pitches at the same time. For example, I have made a crude guitar by stringing a rubber band to a wooden box lid, and I'm going to amplify the sound with a contact mic. A string tied to some wood is a pretty old instrument, and it is monophonic. I can only play one note at a time. When I pluck the string, we hear a low note, but if we listen closely, we might be able to make out another higher pitch. If I run this sound into a tuner, we can see that the number that shows up is about 92 Hz, but sometimes the number comes up 460 Hz. These are both measurements of frequency, measured in Hz, which stands for vibrations per second. The reason for this is discussed in a couple of other videos in this series, but what we can take away from this observation is that we can hear an interval between two notes sounding at the same time on a monophonic instrument. This is also common on instruments where sounds are made by blowing air, like a flute or horn, or even by the human voice. There is a main pitch that is heard, which we call the fundamental, and there are harmonics above that fundamental. A question we might then have is, what can we do to play a higher note with our box and string? If you are familiar with a guitar, you know that you need to put your finger somewhere on the string. Putting our finger on the string in different places is how we can make a melody, and we can make that melody whatever we want. But the types of melodies that stand the test of time are those that others find pleasing. And it's the intervals between notes in these pleasing melodies that leads us to tuning standards that developed through time. The easiest place to start to try to find a higher pitch is, what if we cut the string in half? Because that's a very simple division. On my crude guitar, it is tough to be exact, but I'm going to try it out. And to further investigate, I'll strum the string and then put my finger down halfway and strum again. I'm making a simple two-note melody between the fundamental and a higher note. But there are some times that sound better than others. It sounds better when my finger is really close to halfway along the string. If we analyze the tuning, the higher note that sounds best is close to 184 Hz, which is twice the frequency of the fundamental. What we have just discovered is called the octave. The octave has a frequency that is twice as much as the fundamental frequency, and we can say that the two frequencies have a ratio of 2 to 1. What this means is if I take the fundamental frequency and multiply by 2, I get the frequency of the octave above. If we play this interval of an octave on a piano, both notes sounding at the same time, it sounds like this. On the piano, the string for the higher note is vibrating twice as fast as the string for the lower note. On my crude guitar, when I cut the string in half, the side that I strummed was vibrating twice as fast as the uncut string. If I hold down the string a third of the way between the posts and strum the shorter side, I get an even higher note. This small section is vibrating three times as fast as the uncut string, but it is very difficult to discern the pitch, so I'm going to use our knowledge of the octave to help. This new note has a frequency three times the fundamental, and I will divide that by 2 to move it down an octave. This means the new note has a frequency 3 over 2, or 1.5 times the frequency of the fundamental. And so the ratio between the fundamental and this new pitch is 3 halves to 1. We call this new note a perfect fifth. You can hear a perfect fifth on a piano by starting at middle C, calling it note 1, and counting up to the white keys to G, note 5. If you play the C, the perfect fifth G, in the octave above C, then you hear the three notes we've described so far. And we have another interval we can describe, called the perfect fourth, from G to the octave above C. The ratio for this interval is 2 to 3 halves, or simply 4/3 to 1. We can use this to identify the perfect fourth for our fundamental C, which is the note F. So, using C as a fundamental, we have identified these notes and their intervals based off of the fundamental frequency, which we'll call 1 for the sake of ease. It's a perfect fourth from C to F, a perfect fifth from C to G, and an octave from C to the higher C. But we also discover some more intervals. We have another perfect fifth from F to the higher C, and a new interval from F to G, which we call the major second. The ratio for this interval is 3/2 to 4/3, or simply 9/8 to 1. This means if I take the frequency for F and multiply it by 9/8, then I get the frequency for G. Using our major second ratio of 9/8 to 1, we can fill in some more notes and their intervals. The fractions tell you what to multiply by 1 to go from the frequency of C to any related note. What we have just written down is the Pythagorean scale. The note names are ones that are discussed in music, but we can also just base this all off of a fundamental frequency. We can hear this scale by basing each note off of the fundamental pitch of 92 Hz from my guitar. I can use electronic oscillators to replicate these frequencies and play them back. It should be noted that the intervals just described are not heard in most modern music. The reason for this is it does not transpose to other keys or fundamental frequencies very well. I will demonstrate this problem in the next video and introduce the tuning method that is used in most Western music today.